Yeah.
Welcome back to Yankee Stadium. The pregame ceremonies are about ready to begin here on Yogi Berra Day. Bobby Mercer along with Tim McCarver. Susan Wallman is also with us. It's a hot, humid day. And there's Yogi about ready to enter Yankee Stadium on his day finally. And it all started in New Jersey, as a matter of fact, Tim. There was a little bit of a parade off to the boat that they took from New Jersey, Little Falls, New Jersey, over here to Yankee Stadium and docked up here to this great facility. And about 300 of his closest friends were with him.
Matter of fact, on the way over, they stopped by Gracie Mansion and picked up the mayor. Mayor Rudolph Giuliani riding the last leg of the trip to Yankee Stadium. So many things go through your mind on a day like this. Finally, number 8 is being honored the way he should be honored. And just so many things go through your mind, Bobby, and I'm sure we'll be able to talk with Yogi about all those things during the game.
Well, we talked about Yogi's teammates and friends here with him this afternoon. Susan Waldman is somewhere around the Yankee dugout, and she has somebody there that she wants to talk to, and it looks like an old boyhood friend. So we're going to throw it down to Susan.
Okay, guys. And, of course, I am with, as you described him, Bobby, an old boyhood friend. I'm not sure you describe yourself like that. But talk about your relationship with Yogi all these years. And look at the smile on your face, Joe Garagiola. How happy are you today?
I'm so happy that he's here at Yankee Stadium, and it's where he belongs. And you have to realize, I don't know a day in my life that I didn't know Yogi, because I grew up at 5446. He grew up at 5447. My entire life was as a kid, you know, you choose up sides. The last words I would hear would be, I'll take Lottie. That's what we called him in those days. I'm just thrilled to be here.
And you look at the whole family, and when you think, Joe, that all these grandkids of Yogi's have never seen the kind of ovation he's going to get here.
They feel it, too. They will feel it, and deservedly so. I said to Dale and to Tim, I said, today we lost Joe DiMaggio, but we gained Yogi.
Thanks a lot, Joe Garagiola. And we have to go back upstairs to Bobby Mercer.
Thank you, Susan. And we are about ready to begin the pregame ceremonies. And Michael Kay will be the master of ceremonies this afternoon. And, of course, along with Yogi is certainly his better half, Carmen, his wife, and the children. They will all be here. I like the great line that Yogi had about his relationship with his beautiful wife, Carmen. He says, we have a good time together, even when we're not together. Well, they're together this afternoon on this special day. And now it's throw it down the stairs to Michael Kay, the master of ceremonies for Yogi Berra Day.
It's a pretty good time to be a Yankee fan. You happen to root for the world champions of the world. Your team is now in first place. And Yogi Berra is back. Today, we celebrate the remarkable career and life of a Yankee great, the aforementioned Yogi Berra. He anchored the Yankee dynasties of the late 1940s, the 1950s, and the 1960s, making 15 All-Star and 14 World Series appearances, and earning 3 Most Valuable Player trophies. Yogi shared in an unforgettable Yankee moment when he caught the only perfect game in World Series history. He was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 1972 and still remains an ambassador of this great sport. Yogi always seemed to add a unique philosophical twist to things. In fact, his colorful perspectives became known as Yogiisms and included phrases such as, it ain't over till it's over. Honest and forthright, Yogi is a man who taught us how to dream, reaching unimaginable heights in his career. From a young boy in St. Louis, Yogi Berra transformed himself into a national treasure, a man of conviction and a source of strength to his family, friends, and teammates for nearly 5 decades. Please direct your attention to the Diamond Vision screen as we pay tribute to our humble hero.
trees of green, red roses too. Red roses too. I see them blue for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Yogi Berra. guess you could say that was one more victory lap and a life full of victory laps for Yogi Berra. Yogi's life in baseball spans more than half a century. In that time, the tale of Yogi Berra has flourished. Now I'd like to introduce the people who contributed to some of the most memorable moments in the storybook life of this Yankee great. Please welcome Yogi's loving wife of 50 years, Carmen Berra. His wife, Josie. His sister, Josie, I'm sorry. And his sons, Tim Berra, his wife, Betsy, Dale Berra, Larry Berra, and wife, Carla. Yogi Berra's family. And although they are being introduced on the field, they are watching the festivities from a suite. Yogi's nephew Larry and his nine grandchildren. Our first guest was a durable third baseman that spent eight seasons in pinstripes with an unmatchable World Series batting average of .439. He was also Yogi's very first roommate. Rumor has it that while he was studying medical books, Yogi was reading the comics. They were called up to the majors together and became lifelong friends. Please welcome the former American League president, Dr. Bobby Brown. He spent his entire nine-year career in pinstripes and won six championships. Five of those came during the Yankees' incredible title reign that ran from 1949 to 1953. We're delighted to have him here today. Let's welcome Jerry Coleman. Our next guest holds the Yankee record for wins, strikeouts, ERA, shutouts, and was the ace of the staff on six World Championship teams with Yogi. It's always a pleasure to welcome the chairman of the board, Whitey Ford. Our next guest burst on the baseball scene, winning the 1951 Rookie of the Year. During his 10 years in pinstripes, he played on five championship teams. Join me in welcoming a terrific player and a really classy gentleman, Gil McDougall. He's a longtime teammate and friend of Yogi's, a durable shortstop that spent 13 seasons in pinstripes. He played in 10 World Series. He was the American League MVP in 1950. And after his retirement, he secured a place in our hearts as a Yankee broadcaster. Ladies and gentlemen, the Scooter, Phil Rizzuto. These next three gentlemen were teammates and also played for Yogi when he managed the Yankees to the American League pennant in 1964. Few players have as much personality as our next guest. On four occasions, he hit 25 home runs and won three gold gloves at first base. Let's welcome a fan favorite, Joe Pepitone. He debuted in 1955, and he helped lead the Yankees to World Series titles in 1956, 1958, 1961, and 1962. His scrappy play and timely hitting earned him instant respect from his teammates. He was also one of the stars of Yogi's first day as Yankee manager. Please welcome Bobby Richardson. Our next guest was called up in August of 1964. He won 9 games to propel the Yankees into a comeback pennant victory. He's a 3-time 20-game winner, a Yankee ace for Yogi's first reign as Yankee skipper, and he currently serves as one of the game's best pitching coaches. Let's welcome Mel Stottlemyre. Our next guest was a rock-steady infielder and a dangerous hitter. He had one of his best seasons at the plate under Yogi's tutorage, stroking a career high of 162 hits. He played on 4 pennant winners and is the current Yankee third base coach. Ladies and gentlemen, Willie Randolph. In Yankee history during Yogi's second tenure as manager. He went on to become a batting champion, an MVP, and team captain. Welcome back, number 23, Dunny Baseball, Donald Arthur Mattingly. October 8, 1956, our next guest threw the only perfect game in World Series history on this very spot at Yankee Stadium. Who could forget Yogi in his arms being carried off the field after that final out? Let's welcome Don Larson. Our next guest spent 13 years in the big leagues. He had stops with the Giants, Cardinals, and Phillies, and played against Yogi in the 1964 World Series. He became a member of the Yankee family during his years as a television commentator. He's the former National League president. Let's welcome one of the game's most respected men, Yogi's lifelong friend, Bill White. In the early 1930s, two boys from the Hill in St. Louis, one named Lawrence and the other named Joseph, shared a boyhood dream of becoming big league ball players. They fulfilled that dream and together made the big leagues, becoming household names and lifelong friends. Let's welcome Joe Garagiola. Yogi, today is truly a day for celebration. Your family, friends, teammates, and countless fans have all gathered together to pay homage. At this time in the program, we would like to present you with a few special gifts. First off, the New York Yankees would like to send you and Carmen, ready for this, on a trip to Italy. All you have to do is choose a date. It gets better. Once you've done so, Cardinal O'Connor will work to arrange an audience with the Pope. And who better to present you with a trip to Italy, well, than Phil Rizzuto. As you fans might remember, on October 21st, 1998, the New York Yankees captured their unprecedented 24th World Championships. It was an accomplishment unmatched by any other team in any other sport. And there is no one more appropriate to make the next presentation than the manager of the New York Yankees, Joe Torre.
Yogi, you've been a major part of Yankee history. We're happy you're back for the present and the future. And as a member of the Yankee family, we want to welcome you back with a 1998 championship ring.
In case you haven't seen that ring, it's got the interlocking NY with 24 diamonds representing each championship, and many of them Yogi helped win. In honor of Yogi's wife Carmen's longtime dedication as Yogi's better half, Yankee shortstop Derek Jeter will now present to her a dozen long stem roses. Ladies and gentlemen, Chase Manhattan Bank is the proud sponsor of Yogi Berra Day. Chase Manhattan Bank is also a loyal supporter of the Yogi Berra Museum and a member of the Yankee family. Here to present Yogi with a framed number 8 jersey for display in his museum, please welcome Andy Parton, Vice President of Chase Manhattan Bank. And the uniform has a number 8, no name, of course. Yogi, your Hall of Fame career spanned 10 World Series champions. Through those years, players would give them either a watch or a ring in honor of their accomplishments. Today, the New York Yankees would like to present with you a complete set of your World Series rings. The years 1947, 1949, 1950, 1951, 1952, 1953, 1956, 1958, 1961, and 1962. On behalf of the New York Yankees, Don Mattingly is proud to make this presentation. The Yogi Berra Museum pays homage to the life of Yogi Berra and is committed to the education of young people. The Yankees recognize the sound commitment Yogi has made through his museum and would like to support his efforts in reinforcing the positive effects of sports on children. On behalf of the New York Yankees, Whitey Ford will present a $100,000 donation to the Yogi Berra Museum.
Rose will be happy on you.
Now that is a big check. Yogi, this last gift is not only a Yankee treasure, it's a symbol of what has become a Yankee tradition, the raising of a World Series pennant. Our gift, the original 1951 World Series pennant, is the very same pennant that flew above Yankee Stadium during the year Yogi won his first MVP award, the year that Mickey Mantle and Joe DiMaggio patrolled the Yankee outfield. This 48-year-old artifact is symbolic of Yogi's contribution contribution to the history of this great franchise. And it is our personal gift to you to be displayed in your museum. Here to unfurl the 1951 pennant are Bobby Brown, Jerry Coleman, Gil McDougall, Phil Rizzuto, and Whitey Ford. And that is the original pennant that used to see during Old Timers Day over the facade that rimmed the old stadium. Now these great Yankees will lift up that pennant that means so much to all of you and all of them. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a few words from our distinguished guests. Lawrence, Peter, Yogi, Berra.
Laugh, go ahead. You know, my mother used to say, the two most beautiful buildings in the world were St. Peter's in Rome and Yankee Stadium. My mom was a tremendous honor, and I'm thrilled to share it in this beautiful building with my whole family, my friends, and you fans. You're great. You know, I was proud to be a major league ball player and proud to be a Yankee. A lot of good things have happened to me since I first put on the pinstripes over 50 years ago. I got married to Karn and raised a wonderful family. I played on great teams, great championship teams, and the Yankees also became my family. Well, I want to thank you all for making me feel right at home. God bless you. Thank you.
In his rookie year of 1947 at Sportsman Park in his hometown of St. Louis, at the conclusion of a very special night, Yogi, the guest of honor, added to his repertoire of Yogiisms. He said, "I want to thank all of the people for making this night necessary." Well, Yogi, once again, you are surrounded by people, thousands of them, who think you're pretty special. And on behalf of your family, friends, teammates, and countless fans, the New York Yankees would like to thank you for making today necessary. Thank you, Yogi.
It's about respect, it's about love, it's about friendship, it's about playing baseball. And Yogi Berra, is all of that. What an emotional day for Yogi, Tim, and what a great day here for the Yankee fans, Yankee Stadium. Having Yogi back, from not coming back to Yankee Stadium for the last 14 years, and he talked about this building and how he respected this building. Well, he helped build part of this building, Yankee Stadium.
In Pete Hamill's new book, Why Sinatra Matters, he said that there were three influential, or the most influential, Italian-Americans in this century. Fiorello, LaGuardia, Frank Sinatra, and Joe DiMaggio. Move over, guys. Room for one more, Bobby?
A special one. And that's the guy that everybody loves. We mentioned the most, in my opinion, the most beloved man to ever win pinstripes. His personality is what, not only because of his personality, the way he swung the bat, the way he caught, but the way he has acted as a Yankee and how much he has respected that uniform that he has worn for so many years.
And you know, one of the reasons for that, with the exception of pitchers, no one has ever considered Yogi a threat. Nobody.
Well, we have Susan Wallman downstairs, and she's with another Italian. And he is known by the name of the Scooter. So we're going to set it down to Susan. So.
Okay, and that was a fine introduction by your ex-partner, Bobby Mercer, to introduce Phil Rizzuto. How do you explain this day today? What are your feelings today, Phil?
Well, I tell you, Yogi's the kind of guy that everybody loves. There's no doubt about that. That play, everybody loves Raymond, but more people love Yogi Berra. He's not complicated. He's a lot of fun to be with. You can sit with him all day long and have laughs. And all of those sayings that he said and didn't say that they made up were all true anyway. But I think that Yogi had made so many people happy with the way he played, the way he caught and the way he hit, and then come back and be such a big part of the Yankees that the fans were so upset those, how many years was it?
14.
14 years that he wasn't here. And I kept trying to tell Yogi, it's the fans, forget Steinbrenner. He's, you know, you can always go to Steinbrenner, but the fans are the ones that really want to see you back.
And also his grandchildren, and this was the first time, Phil, that these kids saw the kind of love that Yankee fans feel for Yogi.
Oh, that's true, and he's got such great grandkids. They're all well, they're athletes, most of them are good athletes, and they're just a great family with he and Carmen and the rest of the kids. But that was a great thrill for him. I never thought of that. That's true.
And, of course, we'll have more with Phil Rizzuto because my guess is he's going to go in and say hello to Mercer at some point during this telecast. Thank you, Phil. Back to Bobby and Timmy.
Well, we would love to have Scooter come up here and visit with us, and we might get a few Scooter-isms, Tim.
Everybody loves Raymond and Yogi.
Absolutely. And we all love Yogi today for sure. We'll be back right after this. Please stay with us on Yogi Berra Day.